Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you having a BMW 5 Series generation from year 2010 to year 2017. If you have one of those, they're known as F10 for the sedan, F11 for the station wagon, and you need to remove or replace side view mirrors. Stay with us, we'll explain how to do that step by step. All that will be covered in this video today. Now, let me tell you a little bit about us guys. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission as a shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these free videos. Another thing, if you need to buy any parts, tools for a really good price, quick shipping, save quite a bit of money, check out the link in the description of the video below. Let's go ahead and start on it now. So, now we'll be removing the door panel because we'll be replacing that nasty door handle here. That's a weak spot on BMWs, guys. So let me explain how we're going to do that on this 5 Series. Now there is a few special clips. One is that slides this way. There is one metal one that holds everything in place here. If you go on the bottom, you have lightening. Okay, this is the ambient lightening. If you go like that, you will break it. Don't do that. So come right here. Okay, come in a corner. Start pulling it out. Now, right here, there is one metal clip that you need to come from the bottom, press up. Okay, it came out. I'll show you in just a second, once we remove it, what I'm talking about. Okay, oh, here one of the small clips fell out. Now we come in an angle, come out, up. Slide forward and came out. Now here, two of the metal clips fell out, guys. So those, I need to get them out. Okay, and I need to install them back on the door panel. One right here. I think I saw one. Actually, that came out. Yep, right here. Perfect. And let me install that on the ladder door panel. Okay, right there. So you can see, that's the side clip right here. Now this metal clip over here, guys, you come from underneath, okay, and you just press it and it comes out. Great. We had to do that because we have a hidden bolt here. Let's go ahead and remove that bolt, by the way. Okay, torque 30 right here and pull it out. All right, this one is out. Now we have, guys, okay, a few more things that we need to do. Now, in some cases you may need to remove, okay, the cover for the mirror. In other cases you may not need to. We'll see if it works that way without removing it. If we need more room, we will have to remove it. Now I need to get a plastic prying tool. Here things can go terribly bad. You have one clip that pops really easy on the back. You have one on top, one on bottom that are super tight. And if you pry too hard, you will break them and then that piece will be loose. So I come right here on the back. I release it like that. Then I get a big prying tool, guys. And I come right here and I try to push the whole piece down so it can come out of the clip. But you have the ambient lightening as well, so it's tricky. You have to kind of like see where things are. Okay. And it came out. Now, the bottom one, once the top one comes out, you come like that in an angle. You push up and try to pull it out. Now, one of the clips is right here. Then you have here and here. And let me show you where those clips are on the inside. That can easily break. I'm talking about this one here and this one on top. Right there, that can easily break, by the way. So now we're going to get a Torx 30. Comes out, perfect. Now that's where things get more complicated. That door panel has multiple clips, and if you break some, we'll have a link in the description of the video below where you can get replacements from. What I'm going to do now, I'll get the small prying tool now. Now come in the corner, just trying to fit it somewhere. That is ridiculously tight, by the way. Okay, I went underneath, a paper barcode came out. I'll put another two underneath, fatter one. Then I'll get one more fatter one because you have multiple clips that are super tight. And we kind of like need to pop it loose. Okay. The moment you pop it loose, guys, you get it with fingers. And after that, it goes easy. But the first clips are terrible. Now, here, guys, we're hitting the mirror cover. So, what do we need to do? That mirror cover needs to come out. Okay, let me see which will be the easiest way. From here. Okay, here it comes out. That foam piece with the speaker, with the tweeter here, needs to come out like that. Okay, perfect. Now, let's see if we can gently pull that panel out. Now, one thing that you need to do before we explain about all the clips. On the clips, you should have the black seals installed. If they're stuck on the door, pull them out and install them on the clips, because if you don't, guys, later you have rattle noises coming from the door, so you don't want that to happen. So let me do that before we lose any or we forget about it, right? Okay, one I dropped, and we just have two more. That we need to do. Now all the clips, where they are, we start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 clips, and the door panel comes out. So for the mirror now, guys, okay, let's go ahead, okay, and explain what we need to do here. I'm going to go ahead, okay, let me inspect the cable now. Okay, that's the cable, okay, right here. And how do you guys disconnect it? There is two things that you need to spread to the outside. Okay, to the inside, excuse me, to the inside, those right here, and you pull it out. Perfect, just like that. Now we need to get, okay, Torx 30, and here we need to remove one of the bolts. Okay, that bolt right here. Perfect, this one came out. Now let me inspect everything here, and over there under that seal, okay, we have one more bolt. We need to hold the mirror with one hand, okay? Second bolt. Let's see if we have a third bolt now holding as well. Okay, in some cases you may have a third bolt, in some cases you may not. So we need to inspect everything, okay, and make sure what else we have here. This is the connector. Okay, so let me see. Okay, right here we have a third one, I believe. Okay, under that seal, let me see now. Okay, let me just remove that one. Okay, right here I'm trying to remove it without breaking, so give me just a second. Okay, and we'll continue. So, okay, eventually, guys, I was able to squeeze that thing out. Okay, that's a seal. That's a seal. And right here, let's hold the mirror now. A third bolt. Okay, under this one. Hold the mirror. Perfect. Now let me inspect the... Okay, here. It comes out. Okay, keep coming out. Keep coming out. And this is, guys, okay, the mirror. That's how you guys remove that mirror. So that's how you guys remove the side mirror on a BMW 5 Series. If you need help with anything else, let us know. Hopefully the video will be helpful. And if your mirror doesn't work, we'll have a special video that explains the top reasons why mirror does not work on BMW or any car. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time.